Hey guys, this is a cool little project I wanted to share with you, and it's about running software called Mps-youtube on Raspberry Pi. And if you don't know what Mps-youtube is, it's a piece of software that allows you to play YouTube videos or music in your terminal, so there is no GUI needed. So I build this using stuff lying in my basement. So we've got this free CRT monitor from OLX, and to that we've got attached Raspberry Pi version B running at 700 MHz with 1/2 GB of RAM. And the only things I've got to buy separately for it to work is this USB to PS2 adapter for the keyboard, Wi-Fi dongle. It's a no-name Wi-Fi dongle, which surprisingly works without problems, and this HDMI to VGA adapter. We are running Raspbian on it, and it is connected via this mini jack to RCA adapter to the amplifier right there. Software is basic but really neat. So as you can see, we've got it running here, and we just search for the term we want to search by typing backslash and the thing we want to search. So I will search for a very popular song now, which is Song for Denise. And as you can see, it's searching. And now we've got a list of videos or songs it found. So if I want to play song number one, I'm just typing one. Now we've got to wait a few seconds for it to download. And if it succeeded, it will start playing. So yeah, now I can fast forward a little bit. And yeah, it works. As you can see, we've got controls on the screen. And it's a really neat piece of software for streaming YouTube music on low powered devices. So this project is good if you've got some old computer or Raspberry Pi doing nothing and want to make use of it. But I won't recommend buying it just to do that, because Raspberry Pis aren't very good at producing sounds. They've got problems using full spectrum of frequencies, and it was covered in many articles. Now I will give you a quick rundown what I did to make it work. Here I am connected to Raspberry Pi using SSH on my laptop, so you can see it better. First thing you've got to do is select the audio output. On Raspbian, easiest method to do it is by using raspbconfig. So you just type in sudo raspbconfig. From there you go to advanced options, audio. Now you select if you want your sound playing via HDMI or jack output. I'm choosing jack because that's the way I've got it connected to the amplifier. Next step on the list is downloading the Python package installer. It is needed to install Mps-youtube with it. You can install Mps-youtube straight from the repositories, but unfortunately this version wasn't working well in my case. So to install pip3, you run sudo apt install python3-pip. Now having pip3, we can finally install Mps-youtube. To do that, you run pip3 install --user mps-youtube. For software to run properly, you also need to install YouTube-DL. To do that, you type pip3 install --user YouTube-DL,
And when it's done, you repeat the same command, but you need to add --upgrade. So you've got this software installed, but it won't play music in this state. You need to install additional stream music player for it to work. You can choose either mplayer or mpv. In my case, mplayer did not work properly because it could not play the song till the end. So I am forced to use mpv. To install mpv, you type in sudo apt-get install mpv. Now it's time to run Mps-youtube for the first time. Don't run Mps-youtube as root or superuser because you might run into no sound issues. First thing you've got to do after launching the program is setting a default player. To do that, you type set player and in my case mpv. Theoretically, now the software should be working, but I want to tell you about issue I had. So I was getting an error code 403, which might be caused by too many people using the same API key. To create your own API key, you've got to have Google Developer account. The account is free and you can even use your current one. Having the account, you have to add new project and add YouTube Data API to it. The last thing to do is creating an API key. Now you have to set Mps-youtube to use your API key. To do that, you type set API underscore key and place your API key here. If you ignored my warning and you are running Mps-youtube as a super user, you've got to set API key for super and normal user separately. If you still got code 403, you might want to delete cache file located in Mps-youtube in .config directory. I hope I helped some of you, and yeah, thanks for watching.